أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is indeed his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah. And the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who listen to the best of speech, the book of Allah, and listen to it, and abide by it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who come to know the best of guidance, the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and embark on that path. Allahumma ameen. يا أحباب رسول الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه يقول ربنا جل وعلا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كاف ها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا Allah سبحانه وتعالى tells us in the very beginning of Surah Maryam كاف ها يا عين صاد This is the recital of your Lord upon his servant Zakariya عليه السلام إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا When he cried and called upon his Lord in secret, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي He said, Oh my Lord, my bones have indeed became frail, وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا And my hair is glistened with gray, وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا And never, my Lord, will I be unblessed or miserable because of my prayers to you. This is the first Friday in the year 2012. And how fast time goes by nowadays, subhanallah. Time just literally just cruises by so fast. People would say, I remember when it was Y2K and all that, you know, chaos that was about to take place, potentially would have taken place. And this is 12 years later on. Time passes by and it passes by very quickly. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the passing of time, there is a point behind it. وَجَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ خِلْفَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَن يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا And Allah causes the night and the day to alternate for those who wish to be mindful and for those who wish to be grateful. As time passes by, this is reality. The fact that the years are passing by, this is just part of being human and this is part of the reality of our world. What is more important though is what have we done in the time that was granted to us. And during these times, subhanallah, some have grown and some have grown older. Some have passed away and some just came to this world. But that is again all part of the reality of life. But inshallah today specifically, We're going to mention another reality about this fact of life, time passing by, and we will use Zakariya alayhi salam as an example. Zakariya alayhi salam is talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said that he did so in secret. Nada rabbahu nida'an khafiyya. He called upon his Lord in secret. Zakariya was an old man, and that is part of the reality of what time does to us. Years go by, We get older, and the older we get, life brings its challenges upon us. And Zakariya alayhi salam is speaking about his challenges as an old man. Because see, the Quran is a book that did not leave anyone behind. It spoke to men and it spoke to women. It spoke to the rich and it spoke to the poor. It spoke to the powerful and it spoke to the powerless. It spoke to the young, and it also did not neglect to speak in about the old and also to the old. So Zakariya alayhi salam becomes this manifestation of what it means to be old. So he called upon his Lord and he said, "Oh Allah, nida'an khafiyya qala rabbi inni wahana al'azmu minni." He said, "My Lord, I am indeed at this point, my bones are becoming frail." As people age, and subhanAllah, interestingly speaking, it is expected that by the year 2025, at least over 10% of our population are going to be senior citizens. As we speak today, the fastest growing segment within our population are senior citizens. People growing old. And this has to do with the advancement of medicine. It has to do with the proper care that we're taking care of ourselves. And the reality now is that we are becoming an older generation. In fact, they're expecting in the year 2015 that at least 15% of the population of Pakistan are going to be over 60 years of age. Now, in a way, that is to be celebrated. And also, in a way, it brings challenges. And there are three main challenges that are faced by humans the older that we get. The first one is the very obvious one, and that is physically, we are changed people. The fact that we did all the hustling and the bustling, the fact that we raised kids, the fact that we worked in our youth, that catches up with us later on. And Zakariya alayhi salam is expressing this. Said, "Qala Rabbi inni wahana al'azmu minni." Said, "Oh my Lord, my bones have become frail and they have become weak." And subhanAllah, in physiology, they tell us about the different stages that the weakness of humans go through. Our muscles are initially the ones that get weaker. And then the joints around our bones deteriorate. And then it is the bones that just keep the friction on one another. And that's arthritis. So Zakariya alayhi salam is saying, "Oh Allah, my bones have become frail and they have become weak." So the physical change that takes place at old age, we're talking about people's ability to see better diminishes. We're talking about people not being able to hear as good as they did when they were younger. We're talking about people losing their ability to move as fast as they did when they were younger. We're talking about people reaction time. We're talking about people ability to think clearly and sharply as they did when they were young. Now that starts, decreasing. And unfortunately, in some cases, it goes away. So Zakariya alayhi salam is making his plea to Allah and said, "Allah, I am in this stage." And subhanAllah, sometimes, one of the things that's another challenge that senior citizens have is that how society treats them. Because sometimes we become very impatient. Your parents, "It takes my mom forever to come and get into the car. My dad, every time we have to go anywhere, we have to start getting ready 2 hours ahead because it takes him forever to walk from the house to where the car is parked." And subhanAllah, all people, they feel this. And they feel that they are becoming a burden on society, and unfortunately society treats them that way. Sometimes their own families treat them that way. And that is, you are becoming a burden. So now, because of their physical condition, it is impacting the way that society is behaving towards them. So now people become socially isolated as well, because they cannot bear the way that people are treating them. So Zakariya alayhi salam, he is explaining his situation. He said, "Oh Allah, my bones are weak," and that is just a reality. "My hair is glistened with gray, oh Allah, and at this point, Allah, I can depend on no one but to call upon you." And senior citizens in the Quran are actually a theme that is best represented by the messengers of Allah. First of them, Ibrahim alayhi salam, visited by the angel. And they just come to him all of the sudden, so he does what everybody would do. "Inna munkum wajilun," we are in awe of you. "Qalu la tawjal wa basharuhu bi ghulamin alim." said, don't be afraid of us. We are here to give you the glad tidings of a knowledgeable prophet, young son. And he immediately said, أَبَشَّرْتُمُونِ عَلَىٰ أَمَّسَّنِيَ الْكِبَرِ. You giving me glad tidings because I have become old, because what you are suggesting is really not possible, at least as far as humans are concerned. So they said, it's not that. That is, you cannot go into qunut, you cannot go into despair. But the point is, here is Ibrahim alayhi salam as well as Zakariya alayhi salam, they are both representing to us in the Quran as to what it means to be old. And the Quran subhanallah does not criticize people, nor does Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam criticize people, simply people because people have gotten old, even though sometimes society treats people as a burden. So that is why in the hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ طَالَ عُمُرُهُ وَصَلُّحَ عَمَلُهُ وَشَرُّ النَّاسِ مَنْ طَالَ عُمُرُهُ وَسَاءَ عَمَلُهُ صَلُّوا عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. He said the best of people are those who live long, but in the length of life that they have lived, they have only been committed to that which is good. So these are the best of people. And then he said the worst of people are those who live long and it is only wickedness that they have done. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would pray for this idea of people living long. And he would say, Allahumma ja'alil hayata ziyadatan lana min kulli khayr. O Allah, make any time that is granted to us an increase of goodness in any dimension in life. Ij'alil hayata ziyadatan lana min kulli khayr. Any day that we live, O Allah, we ask that we be increased in any aspect of goodness. Waj'alil mawta rahatan lana min kulli shar. And give us comfort in death from any evil that may be taking place. So old age in Islam is something to be celebrated, especially if a person has lived a life that is consistently good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And that is beautiful, to know that the Messenger of Allah is giving this glad tidings to people who have reached that age, that this is the case. Like I said, even though subhanAllah old age is something to be celebrated, but unfortunately also in the society that we live in today, old people can easily be exploited. One of every 8 cases of domestic violence, the victim is a senior citizen. And most of those, the perpetrators of the abuse, are family members to the senior. And the most common of them are threats. Making threats to old people. I will throw you out. I will leave. I will no longer be with you. And subhanAllah, you know, the older that we get, the more dependent that we become. And one thing that we really want to feel when we are old is that we want to feel safe. So what people do is they abuse this old person by taking that sense of safety away from them, by threatening them, I will leave you. I will throw you in a nursing home. I will throw you in an adult daycare center. I will never come to visit you. And that is unacceptable, brothers and sisters. It gets worse that sometimes people are physically abused. In this old age, people are physically abused. And these are the caregivers, mostly family members, just getting very frustrated with them, choking them, pushing them, slapping them, spitting on their face, simply because it takes you too long to come here. It takes you too long to do things. It takes you too long to respond. We have some senior citizens who say, I don't like to talk to young people anymore. Well, how come? Said that they are very impatient. They don't listen to us. They don't give us our time to respond. It has gotten so bad, and I think I might have told you this before. In Florida, the state of Florida, as you know, good number of senior citizens, because of the climate, they prefer to live there. So the banks found out that these senior citizens come to have transactions in the bank, but that transactions were very sorry and meaningless. Please put $20 in this account and give me $7 from that account and put $2.50 in this account. And they look into all these transactions and they said, these are just meaningless transactions. And it was taking long.
And they found out that these senior citizens have no one to talk to. So the only human communication that they have is with the teller at the bank. So they just want to do the most out of it. So what did the banks do? The bank came up with a policy that said that you can, from now on, you can only come up and talk to the teller twice a month, otherwise we're going to charge you. And these are people who just have no one to talk to. They just want to go out there and talk. And sometimes you'll be at the grocery store and you are at the checkout by the cashier and there is a senior citizen in front of you and they're just taking their sweet time in carrying out a conversation. And here you are boiling and you are all frustrated. Come on, just get it with it and move on. But chances are, this may be the only conversation that they're going to have during the day. And they just want to make the most out of it. So what we see, this challenge of just being socially isolated. Sometimes because of their conditions and sometimes because of those who are around them. Another way that these people are exploited is by taking away their financial assistance. People qualify for different assistance, you know, the older that they get, they pay taxes. So society rewards them in their old age, or society pays them back in their old age. So the caregivers, they end up taking their checks away. You know, your social security, you will not see that. I'll be in charge of it. If you want to stay with me, I will have to keep that money. So now people become not only physically dependent, but now they're also becoming financially dependent on their caregivers. Another way that senior citizens are exploited, identity theft. Identity theft. People come to senior citizens, you know what? I know there is a service for you there. Just give me your name, social security number, and your date of birth, and I'll get you something good. And here, these people are very trusty. Here is this nice young man, nice young woman who are just out there to help. But what they're really doing is that they're exploiting them, stealing their identity to serve their own interests and their own purposes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids this, brothers and sisters. And that is why, subhanAllah, the very first command that Allah gives regarding the parents is one that is amazing. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ. Your Lord has decreed that none is to be worshipped other than Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then immediately Allah says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. He said that, and regarding the parents, deal with them with ihsan. And subhanAllah, they say that there is a reason why that word ihsan is used. Goodness, propriety, kindness. It doesn't say feed them, it doesn't say clothe them. Because sometimes at a certain age, emotional needs are far more superior than physical needs. So Allah, knowing what senior citizens, older people feel like, Allah commands us that chances are children outlive their parents. And parents are going to be old for a while. So in this old age, do not show discontent with your parents. Do not show contentment with your parents. But rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, deal with them with ihsan, goodness and propriety. Simply because of where they are. And that is why this idea of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would praise people who take care, who take good care of their parents. So in Islam, brothers and sisters, our seniors are to be seen as source of wisdom. Because subhanAllah, you know, old age is not all trouble. The image that we have of old people, you know, would be is that they have to be on pills all day long. They're holding their cane. They can no longer walk. And that may be the reality of them physically. But sometimes old age also comes in great ways. People know the reality of life at that point. Do you know what is important and what is not important? They've lived long enough to have many of the answers to many of the questions that we have. Old age, sometimes, yes, it may slow our thinking, but also sometimes it makes people very sharp in their thinking. Some people, even the older they get, the sharper they become. They interviewed this woman. She was 103 years old. Lived to be 103. And they asked her, they said, how does it feel to be 103? She said, it feels great. there is no peer pressure. There aren't many people out there who are 103. So she said, you no longer live life to please your peers or somebody else that is around you. And that is great, subhanAllah. So what we want to do is, number one, celebrate our seniors. Celebrate and also acknowledge their contribution and also acknowledge their difficulties. Reduce ability to clear thinking, lessened hearing, diminished eyesight, difficulty recalling memories, greater weaknesses of the bones. These are, like I said, the physical reality, but also equally as important, brothers and sisters, is not to isolate our senior socially. And that is the third challenge. People who are socially isolated, and people would tell me, my parents never leave the house. And some of us who are immigrants, you have parents, my parents don't drive and they do not speak English. They never leave the house. They become so dependent on their children that the only time that they can get out is when their children are no longer busy. And here you have got these parents that do not feel like they are a priority. And they are stuck at home. They're waiting for you, and all you do, maybe the best, is get them some satellite TV and they will be watching this, and it does nothing but increases their homesickness. So what we want to do is that we want to make sure that we give the utmost due respect to our citizens. And these teachings, they come from the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Prophet, peace be upon him, would praise people, man shaba shaybatan fil Islam, the Prophet, peace be upon him, would see older people and he would so beautifully console them. Say, whoever turns gray while they are in the state of surrendering themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, عَوَّضَهُ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا بِالنُّورِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Say that Allah will compensate them with light in the day of judgment. Because generally speaking, gray hair is a sign of aging. It's not a good sign. So we quickly, you know, try to cover that up. But the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, the more gray that you have while you are surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more light you are going to have in the day of judgment. So number one, please, again, is to celebrate. To make sure that our seniors are not isolated. They say that nowadays in the studies of dementia and Alzheimer's, they're talking about the fact that people who are not mentally active, they have a tendency to develop these things a lot faster than those who are mentally active. And that is why an appeal is made to all of our masajid. See, we have a tendency that our khutbas are geared towards married couple. Our khutbas are geared towards people who are young. How to raise your children so that they have this identity of Islam. And all these topics are very important and they're great and we need more of it. However, there is a segment within our society that has been overlooked. Specifically talking about the need for activities for our older citizens, brothers and sisters. One common mental challenge that these seniors have is depression. People are just absolutely socially isolated. There is no concept of fun or joy in their lives. They lose their appetite. They physically, just imagine, subhanAllah, the older that you grow, there is a point that you may not even be able to dress yourself. There is a point that maybe we may live long enough to the point that we cannot really just take care of basic needs. I cannot put on my own clothes. I have to wait for somebody else to do this for me. Something that we do on regular basis, on daily basis, all the time, now that is all gone from us and we have to be dependent on somebody else to do this to us. And believe me, it's not that bad the way that it's being said. But the point is to appreciate the challenges that our seniors are going through. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثاره اقتفى. As we said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has so beautifully praised life. And he prayed that every day that passes by, may it be an increase in all dimensions of good for us, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And as we, the years go by, brothers and sisters, so does our time. Because the time that we have in this life, the time that is alluded to us in this life, regardless of how long it is, it will eventually come to an end. They said that Wahb ibn Munabbih was once talking. He saw a man. And he looked at him, and the man looked old. He appeared to be old. So he said to him, "Kam umruk?" He said, "How old are you?" And the man said, "Sittuna aman." "I am 60 years old." Wahb ibn Munabbih looked at him and he said, "Wallahi laqad kitta an tasil." He said, "By Allah, you are about to arrive." Meaning that you are about to arrive to your end. So the man looked at him and he was astonished that he's bringing this obvious fact. So he said, "Famal amal?" If that is the case, then what are my options? What do I do? And he so beautifully responded by saying, "Ahsin fi ma baqi, yaghfirullahu ma qad mada." He said, "Be good in that which is left, and Allah will overlook that which has passed away." He said, "Ahsin fi ma baqi, yaghfirullahu ma qad mada." Do good in what remains, and Allah will overlook that which has gone by. Subhanallah, that which has gone by may not be all that great. But they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to hold us accountable on the basis of what we did back in 1979 if we attempt to be better people now. So what we're looking for is this. Regardless of what has happened in the past, these are new beginnings. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَن يَذَّكَرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. 2011 is gone. 1432 is gone. Whatever has happened there, that is all gone. We cannot recall any of it back. But what we have is today, so let us do the best that we can do in whatever time it is that we have. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to do so, Ya Rabbil Alameen. So inshallah, I'm going to make two appeals to you today. Actually, three of them. Number one, please keep the people of Syria in your prayers. You know, there is nothing more wicked in the world than oppression that is practiced by authority. And what we see happening in that part of the world is a lot of oppression, and those who are mitigating that oppression are those who are supposed to be the very people who are supposed to be protecting the masses. Now it is the government that is inflicting most harm upon the masses. And unfortunately for oppressors, oppressors don't learn. People have seen the Mubaraks, the Bin Alis, the Abdullah Saleh, they've seen the Qaddafis, and they still do not heed the lesson. Once people break that barrier of fear, then people are unstoppable. My absolute favorite motto, slogan, that was sung by the people of Syria is one that says, بعد اليوم ما في خوف. Said, beginning today, no more fear. And when people are no longer afraid, then they are unstoppable. When people stop accepting the unacceptable, then at that point people are not defeated. And this is what we see, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy oppressors wherever they may be. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help those who are oppressed wherever they may be, Ya Rabbil Alameen. So please do keep them in your prayers. And like I said, we also have to pay attention to our local challenges, brothers and sisters. See, they say that let's distinguish between two things. The sphere of our concerns is the globe. The circle of our influence is where we are. So let us think globally, but also let us act locally. We may not be able to solve all the problems all over the world, but we can definitely do something about the local challenges that we have. So inshallah, two things. On your way out, we do have a table for Access California, and we do have a program designated to help our senior citizens. If you are a senior citizen, and by the way, the legal definition of a senior citizen is anyone who is over 55. We want you to stop by our table, and we do have some help for the people who are over 55. And inshallah, we do want to share that with you. If you have a parent who is of that age category, please also stop by. If you like to volunteer, please also do stop by. Jazakumullah khair. And then finally, also our annual fundraising for Access is coming up. And it will be, inshallah, on the 28th of January. It is the last Saturday of January. And we would love to see all of you there to support this beautiful local social service organization, the only of its kind here in Southern California. So please make sure that, inshallah, that you do so. اللهم يا رب إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم يا رب فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين اللهم ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وفك أسرانا وعاف مبتلانا واختم بالصالحات الباقيات آجالنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة